Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
God turned his back on the Israelites. Let's find out why. Read. Till they acknowledge their offense. Till they do what? Acknowledge their offense. God said he's going to turn his back on the people on this side, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. He's going to turn his back on us until we acknowledge what we did wrong to him. Read it one more time. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense. So what's the offense? You got to ask yourself, brothers and sisters, what's the offense that we made against God? You probably saying to yourself, how can I offend God? I'm going to show you. We going to show you. When you go against what this Bible says, you are offending God. Right. Read it again. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face. And do what? And seek my face. God said, come find him. Don't go to the Christian church. God is not in the Christian church. Don't go to the Muslim mosque. God is not in the Muslim mosque. Don't run to drugs. Don't run to alcohol. God is not in that. You want to find God? God is right here in this Bible.
That's right.
Read it again. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face. In their affliction, they will seek me out. Now, wait a minute. That's how you know that's black folks. The only time blacks and Hispanics want to pray to God is when something bad happened.
Right.
When these little kids started getting shot, that's when everybody wanted to pray. Fast, you rewind a couple months ago, Negroes was looting all up and down Madison. Tell me I'm lying. Negroes was looting and stealing all through Garfield Park, all through Lundell, all through Inglewood. But then when people start getting killed, Negroes wanted to pray then. God know his people. You can't tell me this ain't blacks and Hispanics. That's the only time we want to pray, when affliction, turmoil, destruction happens to our people. Read it again. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face. In their affliction, they will seek me early. So when bad things happen to us as a people, that is coming from God.
That's right.
Give me Psalms 106 and 43. Why do these bad things happen to us? Why? Why do these bad things happen to us? Is it by coincidence? No. We are going against the very power that made us. Read. The book of Psalms, chapter 106, and verse 43. Many times did he deliver them, but they provoked him with their counsel. Wait. God is going back to when he first started dealing with us. Read that again. Many times did he deliver them, but they provoked him with their counsel and were brought low for their iniquity. Read it again from the top. Many times did he deliver them. Many times did God deliver the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Yes,
out of what? Out of slavery, out of turmoil, out of poverty.
Right.
Look through history, you will see this. He's gonna deliver us again.
Right.
But one thing always happened before the deliverance. We try to go against God, and it never works out for us. But wait a minute. Let's read some more. Read it again.
Many times did he deliver them, but they provoked him with their counsel.
How do we provoke God? You got to ask yourself. How do we provoke God? My sister with the bags. How do we provoke God? How do we provoke God? You ask our people, they don't want to stop. Don't nobody got time for God. But when something bad happens, when there's a rapist going through the neighborhood, when there's constant murder going through a neighborhood, that's when everybody want to do honk for prayer.
They want to have prayer on the nine, prayer visuals. No, get right with God now before he got to take it that far. Read. Many times did he deliver them, but they provoked him with their counsel. You provoke God with birthdays. You provoke God with Christmas. You provoke God with Thanksgiving. Those things are not of God. Thanksgiving is not of God. Birthdays is not of God. Valentine's Day is not of God. Halloween is not of God. Whatever this is set up over here is not of God. You know what today is? Today is the Lord's Sabbath day. You ain't supposed to be buying or selling nothing today because you God's chosen people. Read. Many times did he deliver them, but they provoked him with their counsel. So we provoke God with our wicked ways, and what happened? And we're brought low for their iniquity. We got brought low because of our iniquity. We are in poverty-stricken neighborhoods because of our actions. That's what we out here teaching you today. The ghetto, no matter where you live at, we are the reason we in the ghetto. We do not listen to God. Read it one more time. Many times did he deliver them, but they provoked him with their counsel and were brought low for their iniquity. You are in the ghetto because of your own doing. We used to rule the earth. My brother, you got a few minutes. We used to rule the earth at one point. You got to ask yourself, how was we so mighty as a nation? Now we on the bottom. First fired, last hired. Majority of the people in the unemployment line during COVID was us. I'm going to say it again. Majority of the people in the unemployment line during COVID-19, during all the shutouts, people losing their jobs, was blacks and Hispanics. You got to ask yourself, why is that? Read it one more time. Many times did he deliver them, but they provoked him. Wait a minute. So God ain't got a right to be mad? You got to think about this. God then delivered our people over and over and over again. And what we do, spit in his face by worshiping other gods. Yes, by celebrating your birthday, celebrating Christmas, Kwanzaa. All these things are man-made. Give me Romans 6:23. We want to talk about what's making us fall as a people. We gonna touch on it, because what's the current topic right now? Our people are being gunned down unlawfully by people that hate them. Why is that happening? We gonna see. Read. Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death. Now wait a minute. Many of y'all heard this scripture coming up in church from your grandma, from your auntie. They can quote it, they can recite it, but you never got the full understanding of it. Read. For the wages of sin is death. God is saying the payment for sin is death.
That's right.
So you got to ask yourself, what is sin? What is sin? Give me sin. Read.
The book of 1 John 3:4. Whosoever committed sin transgresses also the law.
Read it again.
Whosoever committed sin.
So wait a minute. Whoever commits sin. Sin is the topic of discussion right now. Whoever commits sin, read.
Transgresses also the law.
Does what?
Transgresses also the law.
Does what?
Transgresses also the law.
Sin is when you transgress God's laws.
That's right.
Transgress means to oppose, break, or go against. That is what we are doing as a people. And we're going to get into some of the things that you oppose God in. Go back to Romans 6:23. We're going to get the understanding. We are in this condition because of sin.
That's right.
Read.
Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death.
So God said, I'm going to make it plain for you. The punishment for breaking his rules is death.
Right.
That is why we as a people, we experience death on a high level because we was given the laws of God. We are supposed to be following the rules of God. We were not meant to be like the other races on this earth. We were meant to rule and put them in order. But because we went against God, we are faced with death and destruction. Read.
For the wages of sin is death.
The payment for breaking his rules is death. Read. But the gift of God is eternal life. They always talking about eternal life in church. You will not get eternal life if you are not doing what God says. Read. But the gift of God is eternal life. The gift of God is eternal life. Read. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. So you must believe in Christ and keep the laws. In church, they tell you not to keep God's laws. That's what's getting you destroyed. Give me Leviticus 19 and 29. We gonna touch on sin. Sin is why we here. Not commit sin is gonna get us out of this situation. So we gonna touch on sin. I'ma let y'all know something. If you hear something come out the Bible and it rub you the wrong way, change. This Bible is a mirror. You gonna see your reflection in it. If you don't like your reflection, change the image in the mirror. Read
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 29. Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
Read it again.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
Understand, we out here for y'all. Don't get timid or hesitant to come up. We out here for y'all. We must come like this because this is an aggressive area. That's why we gotta come like this. Read that again.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
How many people out here got daughters? My sister on the pole right here. Do you have a daughter? I have a daughter. Many of us up here have daughters. Listen to this.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
I'm gonna get right into it, my sister. You went on prom before once in your life, right? Am I right? You went on prom before? When you never went before? But you know when those little boys take the girls to prom, what's their intentions at the end of the night? I can see from right here your reaction. You already know what it is. You know what they talking about after they come from prom. Oh man, Joe, she let me smash. So why in the hell in 2020 are we still letting our daughters go on prom? Our people so destroyed. The schools was closed and Negroes still bought $1,000 dresses to put on their daughter to try to keep the spirit of prom going. If the schools was open, it would have been some little girls getting pregnant. If the schools were still open, it would have been some little girls going on prom getting pregnant by the end of the night. Or getting used and abused. Read it again.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
My sister across the street, is it okay for a young girl to wear just leggings outside? Bring it up. I'ma ask a question, I'ma pose it to the women. Is it okay for little girls to just wear leggings outside?
Teacher.
I'ma ask another question. Is it okay for a little girl to listen to the song WAP?
Bring it out. Is that okay?
Teacher. Is that all right? Teacher. If it's not all right, why do we condone it as a people? Because I can bet you whatever sum of money, the East Indians that's in these stores, the Arabs that's in these stores, they not letting their daughter listen to no damn WAP. But the black and Hispanic woman blast that evil song up and down the street. And you wonder why little girls on YouTube making twerk videos. Little girls getting pregnant at the age of 15 or younger. Little girls catching STDs. Why? Read it again.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be at
home. This gonna hit home right here. How many of y'all let y'all daughter have a boyfriend?
Bring it out.
I don't see no hands raised. My sister right here, the only one who been honest the whole time. You know why? The Bible is showing you your reflection. You let your daughter have a boyfriend, you are prostituting her. I'ma say it again. You let your daughter have a boyfriend, you are prostituting her. My sisters, my mothers, my aunts, my grandmothers out here. How the hell are you letting your daughter have a boyfriend when you know the experience of having a boyfriend? My brothers who have daughters, how you letting your little daughter have a boyfriend when you was once a boyfriend? Boyfriends are temporary men in their life that have sex with them, and when they get tired, they leave them high and dry. Why would you put your daughter through something like that? Read it again.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
Don't nobody want to talk about this. These are things that happen in the black and Hispanic community.
Right.
Yes, Hispanics, you are our brothers and sisters.
Right.
Y'all do the same things we do, if not on a higher level. The black man gang bang, the Hispanic man gang bang.
Right.
He take it to a whole nother level and tat his whole face up.
DJ.
We are brothers. These problems and issues we touching on, we all partake in them as a people, and we need to change.
Right.
Read. Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore, lest the land fall to order. That is what has happened in all of our neighborhoods. Our lands have fallen to whoredom.
My brother,
what's your name? Miguel, come holler at me, bro. I'm out here for you. Okay, you got a flyer? All right, come back and holler at me when you get done. Read that one more time.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
If you allow your daughters to be out here, because as quiet as it's kept, if we ask some of the parents out here, what's your daughter's reputation in Garfield Park? What's your daughter's reputation in Inglewood? You will say she a saint. You will say she's loving. She's good. She's great. But if you ask the brothers on the block, she got a different reputation. Why is that? Because you allowed the behavior. We got to correct what's going on at home. Read.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore. Lest the land fall to whoredom and the land become full of wickedness.
Our neighborhoods are full of wickedness.
That's right.
Baby mamas and baby daddies all around the place. If you're not a baby mama or a baby daddy, guess what? You are a baby of a situation like that. How many of y'all grew up with all your brothers and sisters in the house? Not many. Either your daddy was sleeping with every woman he seen, or your mother was hopping on every ride she seen. Now, they got to pick you up, then pick up your brother, then pick up your sister, then pick up your other brother, then y'all go to one place and spend time together. What type of life is that?
Bring it out.
And we allow that amongst us. The Arab man, all his brothers and sisters from the same man and woman. The Chinese man, all his brothers and sisters from the same man and woman. But when it come to us, oh, yeah, I got 5 brothers on my daddy's side. I got 6 sisters on my mama's side. That's not normal. And you know why it happened? Our land failed to hoard them. Everybody having sex with anybody they want to, without regarding the consequences. Read it one more time.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
You are prostituting your daughter when you allow your daughter to come out here half naked. When you allow your daughter to be out late at night. What's she doing out late at night, 16 years old? And the killer part about it, parents, how many children that went missing in Chicago? I'm gonna bring something back to your attention, because obviously it has not been taken care of. 4 girls went missing on the west side. They found 2 dead and never said how they died. Don't nobody care nothing about that? No, you just go on about your life. But you want solutions as to why the neighborhood is like that? Step forward. Read it again.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore, lest the land fall to whoredom and the land become full of wickedness.
When you got events like this, everybody come out dressed and impressed. Brothers got their fresh J's on, Joe Rodeo on, G-Shock watch, all that. Mike's on. Why? Because they know the women out here. A lot of brothers finna get numbers from your daughter and probably sleep with them a couple weeks later. And it's because you let them outside, you let them go be free, as they say. Oh, my daughter a free spirit. Then she gonna be what we reading. Ain't no free spirit in your household. You can't allow that junk. So Rock 42 and 10. It's not right to have children as a child and you in your mother's house. We gotta get that out of our brain. The other nations don't allow it. Why do we allow it as a people? My brother, you got a minute? Is it okay for a teenager to have babies and they still in their mama house? No. So why do we allow it as a people?
I don't allow it.
You said you don't allow it. That same mentality all the men supposed to have. But obviously we don't. You know some young kids who got babies in their mama house, don't you? 15, 16, she got a baby. The mother let her go back out into the street, rip and run, get pregnant again, while the grandma watched the babies. Read that. Surah, chapter 42, and verse 10. In her virginity, lest she should be defiled, and gotten with child in her father's house. Wait a minute, what that say? In her virginity, lest she should be defiled, and gotten, be what? Defiled. Be what? Defiled. A lot of parents fail at this. You let your young daughter rip and run and she got defiled, having sex at an early age. Ain't no child supposed to be thinking about no sex, but they gonna think about it if you let them get exposed to certain things. Read that again. In her virginity, lest she should be defiled, and gotten with child in her father's house. And what? And gotten with child in her father's house. It used to be a time before our time, if a young girl got pregnant, they sent her down to another state to live because it was a shame.
Right.
Your daughter, how old? She got a baby? It was a shame. Now we have become a shameless people.
Teach.
We allow lewd and cruel behavior and see nothing wrong with it. Read on. And having a husband, lest she should misbehave herself. And when she is married, lest she should be barren. Read it again. Lest she should what? Lest she should be barren. Misbehave. And when she is married, no, misbehave herself. And when she is married, lest she should be barren. So what is that saying? Young girls is supposed to be groomed on how to be a wife so they can be married.
That's right.
Read that. Keep a sure watch over a shameless daughter. Read that again. And guess what? We ain't going to be getting on the sisters too long. We finna start talking about the brothers. Read. Keep a sure watch over a shameless daughter. So, mothers, if you know your daughter is quote-unquote fast, what did God say do? If your daughter fast, what God say do to her? Keep a sure watch over a shameless daughter. If you know she don't got no self-respect, she don't need to get that much freedom.
Bring it out.
Read it again. Keep a sure watch over a shameless daughter. Why? Lest she make thee a laughing stock to thy enemies. As quiet as this kept, some of your daughters are an embarrassment to you.
That's right.
Why? Because you didn't start from young keeping them in order. You let them run rampant, wild and free. Now they are an embarrassment to the family. Some of y'all won't say it, but some of your daughters, you don't even want coming around nobody. Because they ratchet.
Right.
Don't care.
Right.
Cuss. Every word come out their mouth a cuss word. She smoked cigarettes. She smoked blunts. Her butt always hanging out. But it started at home. What was you doing, mother? What was you doing, father? Let's correct the issues.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.